basically it's sort of inspired by my parents' marriage, tempestuous relationship, and I've been kind of thinking about it for a long time and thinking, but will I ever find actors who can be these people? And very quickly I knew such an actress, and it was Joanna.
Oh, she was so emotional and very, very open. Great person, but with something very deep and dark inside her personality.
When I was writing and kind of rewriting and thinking of these crazy scenes, you know, jumping into the river, jumping onto a bar and falling off it, and I just thought, oh God, I kept imagining Joanna doing it, and it felt good, it felt right. I needed a proper leading man in this film, you know, a kind of pre-war type of an actor. Somebody who is sort of manly in this old-fashioned way, but not macho. And Tomasz had that. He has that aura. He definitely has these qualities.
Jak długo jeszcze będziecie w Paryżu?
Jutro wracamy. Jak ci się tu żyje?
Jakoś idzie. Aranżuje, komponuje. Gram w klubie. Ogólnie dobrze.
I think Łukasz, we're both working on the image together, and it works very well. You know, there's no, you know, we're like one mind in a way. And that level of enthusiasm and commitment is very rare. Also, he's interested in what I'm interested in sculpting. You know, it's not like I pre-draw the film, you know, I kind of just create the situation and add things, take things away. Change the framing a bit, change the lighting a bit, change the acting a bit, change the dialogue a bit, you know, sort of image and performance and camera movement is part of the same process.
Bonsoir.
Pardon, bonsoir.
J'ai beaucoup pensé sur votre texte.
Ah oui, quel texte?
De ma chanson.
Ah, bah oui.
Black and white was the obvious choice because, for one thing, Poland wasn't terribly colorful in the early 50s, so any kind of color that I could have come up with just would feel rather arbitrary and contrived. And black and white helped us to make it really dynamic. You know, we went for a really contrasty black and white, you know, with a real bite, you know, so it helped to make the film really dynamic and dramatic. And also, although it's square, this format, you know, you can create a world behind, you know. So in this film especially, we composed in depth, you know, so there's kind of layers and layers of stuff that happens behind the heroes. I like to guide where the viewer is looking and to work by suggestion, so not to show everything, but to kind of hint at things that are happening out of shot. What makes me happy is to be able to shoot scenes where everything comes together. The performance, the framing, the lighting, the movement, the background movement. And it's a kind of high wire act to shoot like that without coverage, you know, just kind of try and condense everything and put everything in this one shot. You know, when you get that right, it's kind of magical. That's the magic of cinema for me. I just want to tell a story of two characters I'm interested in, and these characters are a bit like my parents, some parallels, they're a bit like people I know from my past. They're a bit like me and a lot of people I know, a kind of relationship between man and woman. The only difference is that they are living historical time. And a world which is suffused with nostalgia in a way. I mean, it's a horrible time for most people. But looking back at it, you know, they had some kind of pathos to them and clarity and people had clear decisions to make and I like that.
Zula się nie przejmuj. Będzie jak ma być.
I like this film. I think the film is about love, it's about separation, it's about imagining the object of your love is somebody else that who they really are and discovering who they really are and then still loving them. It's about how inconstant everything is and yet how sometimes you're just fated to be with this one person.
Stop!
Cut, stop, stop.